Welcome to the 2006 highlight video of the Mt Vernon Rams. Once again, the Rams made an appearance in postseason playoff action. We're about to show you the key offensive and defensive highlights for each of the 10 football games. But before we get to those highlights, we're going to let each of the 14 seniors tell you what the Mt Vernon Township High School football program has meant to them.
Williams. And this program to me is more than just a program. It's been a family away from home. Whether it's the weight room or the locker room, the game field, practice field, or running plays in the gym, this team has been so much to me, and I'm really going to miss it.
It's Adam Miller. Everybody calls me Ogre, though, you know. This program has been about parents, about family and everything. Still, that's wrong. But I've really enjoyed my time with the football team. It's been rough. We've had a good times and bad times. But yeah, it's been great. Seniors?
Eric Stuckey. And while I've been in this program, I've met a lot of guys that I'll never forget. And I'm going to miss this team. But
hello there, my name is Matt Williams, and we call me Will. The football program has shown me that you aren't really much of a family, you know? And without this program, I wouldn't be as good of a man as I am right now.
I'm Jordan Clinton, and football has just been something that I can rely on. It's always been here for me. All the coaches do a really good job with giving you that, you know, the second father feeling. And it's just a good feeling knowing that there's a second family out there. There's something going on with yours. There's another group to come to, another support. And some stuff happens. You get to run a lot. But you know what comes with it. It's a good time. It's a good time.
Hi, I'm Jess Sharkarian. The football program here at Mt Vernon has meant a lot to me. Coaches have always been real supportive and always been great. And I love playing football. I love competing out on Friday nights or Saturdays. It's just been incredible. It's meant more to me than any other sport I've ever played. And I'm going to miss it so much.
I'm Miss Simmons. I don't know. I've done football since probably sixth grade. And all through high school and everything. It was a lot of hard work. I probably complained a lot and everything, but it was good for me. I enjoyed it a lot. And I'm going to miss padding up on Friday nights and Saturdays, like Jeff said. And I don't know, it's been good for me, keeping me in shape and stuff like that, and giving me a reason to stay in shape and work hard for the coaches. And like you said before, my coaches have always been there for us. And if I had any questions about anything, I talked to them about it. And, it's been a big part of my life because we're football year-round, almost, now it's over. I don't almost know what to do. So, but I don't have any regrets playing it.
I'm Derek Elvis. Football program to me has been a lot. Coaches are great, and I'm gonna really miss Friday nights. I love having the friendships that I've made over here, and I just love the game. I'm gonna miss a lot.
I'm Nick Bradford. The football program has taught me how to like to be good friends with people, be bonds, and show each other the best you can do.
Hi, my name is Matt Hester. The football program has helped me a lot in life. It's taught me respect and a whole bunch of different stuff. Kept me in shape. The running was hard and stuff, but in the end it all works out and I won't miss it. Up and everything.
Hey, I'm Paul Hart. Football program here has been awesome for the last 4 years. Like Mitch said, it's been all year round. We've always had something to do. And now it's over, it's just going to be weird, like finding stuff to do. Hopefully we'll still live together, and you know. But we're going to come away with it. A lot of great stories. The coaches were awesome. A lot of funny times together. A lot of great times together. Playoffs are awesome. I got hurt a lot, and mostly long snap, but I still had a great time. So that's about it.
Nick Bradford, the football program has taught me how to be a good leader, and you get really good bonds with friends. It's taught me to smile a lot, I like to do that, and get good hits. I got lots of memories and scars from all the good times I have with buddies.
Yeah. All right, my name's Doug Mark. All the guys here are real good guys. The coaches are pretty good, and I think we'll be friends for a long time.
And I think the coaches are really nice, and they do a good job. And I'll probably miss football because I like when you hit people. And when you hurt yourself, that's when you know you did right. So when you hit somebody hard enough that you hurt yourself.
Hi, my name is Jeremiah McGovern, and I've been playing football for 7 years now, and I'm a senior, and I just graduated. And the football program basically, I think, teaches someone a lot about life, I guess, and, you know, kind of shows them a lot of life lessons, you know, never give up, keep after it. You know, it shows you a lot about family, I guess, and, you know, how to stay together and be brothers and, you know, be there for someone and let you know that, you know, you always have someone there for you as well. So basically the program, I guess, is just, you know, it keeps kids active, you know, keeps them out of trouble, hopefully, and, you know, it just shows them a lot about life. So I think basically that's what I've got from it.
Kickoff and it's underway.
It's going to be Dontrell Black.
Dontrell Black, number 7, picks it up at about his 10-yard line. He's across the 30, still on his feet across the 40. He might break and go all the way, Marty.
I don't see any flags.
Nobody's going to stop him.
I don't see any flags, and what a way to start the year. 90.
Unbelievable. Opening kickoff return.
95 yards for a touchdown.
Well, we said at the beginning of the broadcast that the Rams have a lot of speed this year, and they just showed it right out of the gate. As Dontrell Black went coast to coast, 95 yards for an opening touchdown for the Rams, and just like that, it's 6-0.
Andy, I'm not. I like it.
Oh,
he's
look at
gone.
That misdirection. Yes, look at that speed. Unbelievable. Dontrell Black all the way into the end zone.
Nicely executed.
First down for the Lancers. They spotted at the 31-yard line. Under center, Jacob Powell, the quarterback, and he hands off, and there's a good hit. In the backfield that time, as Wallace is stacked up.
That's that Bradford kid. He's quick off the ball. Nick Bradford gets right in there and grabs the legs. He's not going anywhere.
Lost his helmet on that one, but it was sure worth it, wasn't it? Here's the snap.
Or give it to Chicken Stuckey and let him carry it in.
It's a touchdown as he gets it over the goal line, and the Chicken Man puts the Rams in the lead by a score of 19-14. Great drive there by the Rams.
He's going to throw it.
Hester wants to throw it. He does cross midfield. Oh, almost intercepted. A good play there as Dontrell Black went and fought for the ball and came away with it. And look at this. He's going to race up the left sideline.
Wow.
Turns it into a great gain. It was almost a disaster.
Yes, it was.
And it was really a jump ball on the backfield, and Dontrell Black was very aggressive and went after it, won the jump ball, and then took it and ran it up the sideline for a huge gain up into Lancers territory. The Rams do here on 2nd and 5.
Joe Rush got some room. One got to be.
He breaks it. He's gone.
He can run. He can run. The other guy's got the angle.
Oh, boy.
What a run.
Great pickup, almost broke it to the house, but he's run out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Is again, Joel Rush showing a burst of speed tonight. And I'll tell you what, no matter which one of the three guys or the three-headed monster you give it to, Marty, they've all got great quickness, great explosiveness, and you saw it right there. And the ability to break tackles, too. We've seen that all night long.
61 yards on that carry.
5.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Clock rolling as Hester takes a snap.
Stuckey again.
There it is. Along the right side of the line and into the end zone. He scores. Touchdown, Rams. As Chicken Stuckey gets into the end zone, and the Rams go up by 13 points now. It's 27-14. Another impressive drive by the Mount Vernon Rams here in the third quarter at Belleville East. And they'll try to tack on the extra point now. As Michael Swinnen will come in to do the honors. And the kick is up, and it's good this time. Clock running with a minute 19 left. Ball down to the 2-yard line. Getting tense, Marty.
Knocking on the door.
Powell with the snap. Hands it off on the middle. Oh! And the Rams stop him, I believe.
Did not get in.
A great goal line stand that time by the Rams.
Number 72 for Mount Vernon.
Just stood him up.
Adam Miller right there on the bottom of that pile.
Under a minute left to play now. Clock continues to run. It's going to be third down and goal. Ball resting on the 1-foot line. Let's go defense. Clock running with 39 seconds left in the game.
Fumble!
Who's got it?
We got it!
Rams recover the fumble.
What a time for the first turnover in the game.
Wow. Yes.
Wow.
Just when you needed something special to happen,
something special
did happen.
Yeah, Jake Powell pulls out a little bit early and the ball goes to the ground. I did not see who got the recovery by the look of things. Looked like Adam Miller running off that field to be a happy camper.
And that's going to be it as the Belleville East coaching staff starts to walk across the field to meet with the Rams, and the Rams are jubilant as they win this one by the score of 28-20 over the Belleville East Lancers in the season opener for both ball clubs. And Rams showing blitz. We got three wideouts again, and there
in the
backfield. There's the fumble, and it's picked up by the Rams.
Ooh, yeah,
and I believe
beautiful.
Nick Bradford got on it.
Jake Sledge knocked it loose. Jake Sledge got the penetration and made the hit.
And Nick Bradford, the senior, jumped on the football, and the Rams will take over at their own 40-yard line, and that was the defensive play and the turnover we were looking for, Marty. Rams looking for their second straight win. Oh,
Rush
nice
open.
Speed that time. Joel
He's
Rush
open.
Gets the ball. The second man through, and he turns the corner, and he may be gone.
He is gone.
It's a touchdown, Rams, 49 yards for
yes,
Joel
sir.
Rush. Well, that was a great fake. As Hester faked it to one back going one direction, reverse went back the other way, gave it to Rush. Rush turned the corner quickly on the left side, and he was off and running, and nobody could catch him because, again, that Bison defense, Marty, was in so tight, they didn't have anybody out wide, and it was too late.
Yeah, good blocking on the offensive line. They sealed it in, a little misdirection play, and as soon as he hit that corner, he was gone.
Extra point attempt coming up now. Michael Swinnen out there to try to kick it through the uprights. And Hester on the hold. The kick is up. It's good. Just like that, the Rams take the lead by the score of 7-0. Padlow wants to throw again. He drops back. Can't find a receiver. He's pursued by the Rams. He's brought down on a loss this time.
Chicken Stucky Jake Sledge.
Great pursuit by Sledge and Stuckey as they threw him for a good loss in the backfield, back to about the almost the 29-yard line. A loss of 9 yards. You see the ball resting just beyond the 30-yard line. Rams with first and 10. Tied up here in the second quarter. Hester gives it back. On the pitch
back
to Dontrell Black.
He's
and look
gone.
At that. He breaks through the defenders.
No
he
flags.
He is off to the races. Nobody's going to catch him. I don't see any yellow anywhere. Nothing but green pastures out there. As
70-yarder.
The long touchdown run by Dontrell Black, and the three-headed monster strikes again. It looks like the cheerleaders are going to have to do a lot of push-ups here in a moment, aren't they?
Yeah.
Michael Swinnen is on for the extra point attempt. Hester on the hold again. Swinnen puts it up. Oh, plenty of leg. Good looking kick. Plenty of leg by Swinnen. And the Rams go up now by a score of 14-7.
Interesting. 7-yard line, and they're going for it.
Must not have too much faith in their kicker, huh?
Evidently not.
All right, Ram fans are on their feet. Let's see what the Bison try to do on this. They're going to spread the field out. Two wideouts on each side. Padlo under center. Takes a snap. He wants to throw it.
Oh, he fell down. He fell down. That's good. All the way back.
Intercepted by Joel Rush of the Rams. As he brings it upfield, gets up over the 40-yard line, up to about the 47-yard line, and the Rams will take over there after the big interception in the end zone by Joel Rush. Wow.
The big defense, play.
The defense does it again, Marty.
Yep, big play. Turnover number two, just like last week, at the goal line.
Hester looking for receivers. He rolls out, throws it downfield.
He's open.
Deep. There he is. He's got it. Pass complete to Chris Bradford. He catches it and gets it over the 10-yard line, down to about the 8 or 9. And, boy, he just caught the Bison defense unaware of that time. No flags on the play. It's a Ram first down. Deep.
60-yard play.
Benton territory. Mr. takes the snap.
Dontrell.
Dontrell Black gets it in the end zone. It's a touchdown. Touchdown, Mount Vernon, as the Rams fans come to their feet again. 20-7. First down at about the 48-yard line. Across the pass again. Padlo.
Joel Rush.
There it is. Another interception by Joel Rush as he steps right in front of
good
the intended job. Receiver at the 30-yard line. It's another turnover, and the Rams will take over at their own 30-yard line. Good defensive play there by Joel Rush.
Off to a great start.
Oh, yeah.
Good blocking.
Off to Joel Rush. He's got that explosive speed. He turns the corner. He's got one man to beat, and he's wrestled down at about the 29-yard line, but a great gain by Joel Rush. Stopped on the play by Ricky Baker.
38-yard pickup, I think.
Wow. Bison operating there. First and 18.
Got a Joel Rush trifecta.
Two wideouts to the right. Back to passes. Padlo. Sledge misses him. Now he tries to get away. Rams pursue again, and great
Nick
stop
Bradford.
By Bradford. Nick Bradford finally fought off his defender and grabbed Padlo and brought him down to the ground at, maybe a loss of one.
I think
it's third down and 3. Ball resting at the 27-yard line.
I think it's time for that fake pitch and handoff. Dontrell Black up the sideline.
Here is the pitch. And it's back to Dontrell Black, and he's got running room, and he may go all the way. He breaks into the secondary, and they won't catch him. He is gone. 73 yards for the touchdown. Dontrell Black, and even the official fell down on that one. Fans are on their feet. 73-yard touchdown run by Dontrell Black. He found the seam, and he was gone, Marty.
Touchdown number 3 on the day for Dontrell.
This is old hat for him.
I'd say. You can't hold him down for 4 quarters.
Three-headed monster strikes again. It's 27-14 as Indu kick the extra point. Now is Michael Swinnen. And the snap is down. Kick is up, and it is good. Michael Swinnen is 4-for-4 on the day on the extra point department. And the Rams extend their lead to 28-14. Well, and the Ram cheerleaders will be trying to do some more push-ups down there at the end zone underneath the scoreboard. 28 of them to be exact, as the Rams lead it now 28-14 with 10:05 left to go in the ball game. Defense needs a turnover, need a big stop.
Yeah.
And there it is.
Number 72. Adam Miller on the tackle.
Handoff was up the middle, and he had nowhere to go on that one. Ram fans are on their feet. Clock is running. 41 seconds left in the ballgame. Rams clinging to a 7-point lead, 28-21. From the shotgun, Padlow looks to throw it. He does. Down the sideline, and it's picked off by the Rams. A deflection. It's intercepted by Dontrell Black. Bringing it back the other way. He's across the 20, the 25. Stiff arms his man and is brought down at the 30 with 19 seconds left on the clock. And spot on the board. All right, here we go. Third down and four. Here is a handoff to Dontrell Black, and he is into the end zone. It's a touchdown from 14 yards out. Rams are on the board.
Did you see who was leading that play right there? That was big number 67, the center, Jordan Clinton, and he cleared the way, and Dontrell Black cut it up there. Pay dirt.
Well, this is going to be a key play in the contest.
Yeah, and you never know with Dan Mings. This might even be four down territory here, and I got no problem with that. Let's get first downs.
Under 9 minutes to play now here in the second quarter. Rams with everybody in tight. Triad in a 5-5-1 defensively there, an interesting defensive look. They got everybody in tight. Let's see if we can bust one wide. Looks like Hester's going to throw it as he drops back to pass, and he hits a big tight end over the middle. It's Sean Weigel. He's going to rumble for a touchdown. Nope, he's short. They caught him from behind. I thought he had open field in front of him, but they caught up with him with their speed and brought him down at about the 15-yard line. As we zoom in, you see exactly how close that ball is to the goal line as the Rams try to punch it in here for another score in the second quarter. Game is tied at 7-7.
About a quarterback sneak over Jordan Clinton right here. That looks sweet.
We got double wideouts here as we spread the offense. It's a quarterback sneak. You called it, Marty. Did he get in?
And he did.
He is in. It's a touchdown, Rams. Matt Hester just duck his head and followed big Jordan Clinton into the end zone.
See if they can
see if they get the play off in time. Elliot Corey seemed to be a little confused on what they were going to do. He's got it. He rolls out, wants to throw it. He throws it deep. He's got a receiver down there. He's well covered, and it's knocked out.
Great job of defense. Great job by Mitch Simmons.
Great play.
Step for step. Really a good job. Stayed with him step for step.
He was right with him down the sideline and kept his eye on the ball and could feel the receiver behind him and just kind of stepped in front and knocked it away, and it was a great play. So it's incomplete, brings up fourth down, and that's going to force the first punt of this football game by either team. Clock rolling, 9:24 to play here in the third quarter. Third down and five at the 42 of the Rams are the Triad Knights. Man is in motion is Jones, and
fumble.
A fumble, and the quarterback picks it up. And he's pursued by the Rams,
yeah.
And he's brought down for a big loss.
Jake Sledge.
As Sledge is back there to pounce on him along with a little help from Nick Bradford. And fortunately for Triad, Elliot Corey was able to pick that fumble up. So we're going to try the field goal here by the freshman Michael Swinnen. And the ball will be spotted at the 22-yard line, so it'll be a 32-yard field goal attempt here by Michael Swinnen.
Yeah, it'll be Paul Hart, the snapper, to Matt Hester, the holder, to Swinnen.
Snap is good. Kick is up. It looks good. Is it good? Yes.
It is good.
A 32-yard field goal by the freshman, Michael Swinnen. And the Rams put three more points on the board, courtesy of the freshman, Michael Swinnen. And after 15 seconds to go here in the third quarter, Rams leading it by 3 points at 17-14 as they try to answer back now after the recent score by Triad. Hester's going to hand it off, and he does. He's breaking away.
Gone.
There he goes. It's Joel Rush.
He's gone. No flags.
It's a race. It's a track meet, and he's going to win it. Joel Rush.
3 yards.
I don't think anybody touched him. That was a big hole that time. Opened up on the left side of the line, and Joel Rush plugged that hole and took it to the promised land.
Sure did.
63 yards.
Right here, that's where you got a root hog root. Those offensive linemen, Eric Stuckey, Jesse R. Curry, Jordan Clinton, Ian Reagan, and who am I missing? Doug Martin in there also. He's been moved to the tackle spot, so we need to declare us the stronger of the two teams.
You know, those guys just don't get enough credit for the great job that they do. As you see a close-up of them there on the line, as they are really opening up the holes tonight for the Rams. Okay, Hester takes a snap again. And he gives it to Rush. Rush back the other way on the reversal. Breaks into the secondary. Will he go all the way? One man to beat. He drags the ground from behind. He breaks free and scores. Long touchdown run by Joel Rush.
And no flags on the field.
43-yard TD run by Joel Rush. Great second effort there as he broke not one but two tackles, including one down close to the goal line, and fights his way into the end zone for another big score for the Mount Vernon Rams. Wow, what can you say, Marty?
I can say that he's got 173 yards rushing now.
What a night for Joel Rush. And here comes the freshman again, Michael Swinnen, trying to tack on the extra point. Here we go. The kick is up, and he's perfect again. How about that? And it looks like it's going to be a third straight victory for the Rams as we got to snap the ball one more time here, Marty.
Mm-hmm.
There's the snap, there's the knee, and that's going to be victory for the Rams.
Yeah, you got to love it.
13 seconds left. Triad can't do anything as the clock continues to run. It's going to be the victory for Mount Vernon as the players and coaches come out and meet each other at midfield, and you got to love it. Rams pick up their third straight victory, but it was not easy tonight as coaches meet there at midfield. Rams win this one by the score of 31-28, another epic battle between the Mount Vernon Rams and the Triad Knights. Wow, what a football game.
Awesome.
Hester looks over at the sideline, gets this signal from Steve McCoy, and now here's a fake one way, hand off the other way to Joel Rush. Rush has got daylight and goes quickly into the secondary, almost breaks it, gets well into Crusader territory up to the 43-yard line, and we've seen that play work many times this year already, Marty.
Yes, we have, and a good misdirection play where we fake one way and hand it to Joel going the other way, and he hit that hole, and one guy to beat, and he would have been gone.
As you see, the Crusader defense digging in here.
Boy, and they're just giving them different look after different look. This time they're going with a three-man front, and we got some room.
Here's a quick give. Look at that. Joel Rush is going to bust it all the way into the end zone. He followed his block and then cut it to the outside. And again, I think he was untouched into the end zone, Marty. 23 yards. 23 yards for the score as Joel Rush shows a burst of speed there, and the Rams are on the board. It's a quick timeout, Marty, as we come back to action here.
It is a fake.
It is a fake, and it's a snap to Alvis. And Alvis,
I think he got it.
Picks up the first down. Alvis was the up man on the snap. The ball was snapped directly to Alvis. He took off running along the right-hand side of the line, and he picks up the first down for the Rams.
Well, I tell you, got a little nervous when he was running sideways there, a little juking there, and they cut it upfield and had just enough steam to cover the 4 yards needed for the first down.
It comes at a very good time in the ball game. Second quarter action with 6:45 to play. Rams trailing 12-7. Now here's the handoff. Up the middle. Look at this. Joel Rush breaks it up over midfield as he explodes into the Crusader secondary.
You know, we were marching the ball, the fake punt, momentum going our way. And, you know, now the Crusaders bring Big Mo over to their side with the interception and second turnover of the night. And they're going for the screen pass right here to Ford. Good hit.
Ford is hit hard after he catches the screen pass. He's not going anywhere on that play. Young again with the snap. And he's brought down on the sack.
Jake Sledge
penetrated into the backfield and hit him from behind. Great sack there by Jake Sledge, and that brings the Ram crowd to their feet. Clock is running. It is first down and goal for the Rams. They've got it spotted on the 6-yard line. Let's see what happens here on first and goal. Everybody in tight. Seven defenders up on the line for the Crusaders. Here's a give to, is it Black or Chicken?
I think it was Chicken Stuckey, and the touchdown has been called.
They were running side by side into the end zone, and Chicken Stuckey gets the score from 6 yards out. I think Dontrell was kind of giving him a little side-by-side excursion into the end zone there. Rams take the lead 13-12, and now four-man front this time by the Crusaders.
Rams all time.
And here's the pitch.
He's gone.
Dontrell Black as he breaks free down the left sideline, and it's open season all the way to the end zone. The Crusaders were stacked up in tight that time, and Dontrell Black broke out to the left side, and once he busts through that initial hole.
Well, that's what I said, Randy.
Wide
with, that,
open.
With those stunning linebackers, a split second there was the difference between a negative loss and a 36-yard touchdown run, and Dontrell had the speed and the quickness to get through before those linebackers got their paws on him.
And here's a big extra point attempt coming up now as the freshman Michael Swinton will try to tie the game, and he does! 7:16 to go in the ballgame. Crusaders leading it 27-20. This is the South 7 Conference opener for both schools. Winner tonight will somewhat be in the driver's seat, but it's still a long season. And here's the give on the reverse. Back the other direction. It's Joel Rush. Look at this. He's got running room. Can he break it all the way? He cuts back. He spins and breaks another tackle. He may go all the way. One person to beat. A good block by the Rams. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Touchdown. 73 yards for Joel Rush. And how about the block at the end by, was that Andrew? Who was that? Andrew Seagraves? Or?
Joel
Unbelievable.
Rush.
73 yards. And the block at the end, was that Sterling Williams or was that? Boy, that was a great block down by the goal line. That'll be one you'll want to watch back on the highlights on the sports couch tomorrow morning.
They all had a shot at him, didn't they?
They sure did. But nobody got him, and he did a great job of cutting back. And here's the kick by Michael Swinton, the freshman, and the ball game is tied. But you have to tip your cap to the Belleville All-Talk Crusaders. They played a great football game. They forced the turnovers.
Mm-hmm. And really a closer game than 41-27 would indicate, I think. But 3 minutes into the game, Randy, we've got an extremely crucial play. That's a long 1 yard line, or 1 yard to get.
Let's see what the Rams do. On fourth down, Matt Hester under center. Takes the snap. He hands it to Chicken Stuckey. He breaks into
he's
the
gone.
Backfield, and he's gone in the secondary. Nobody's going to stop him, and it's going to be a touchdown for the Rams. Chicken Stuckey takes it all the way. 46 yards for a Ram touchdown, and just like that, Mount Vernon is on the board here in the first quarter on their opening possession of the game. This will be third down and goal from the three. Brown shouting out instructions to his receivers as they spread it out again. From the shotgun, he's going to hand it off again. Sweeping to the right-hand side, and he's stopped short as Chicken Stuckey penetrated in and grabbed hold of Porte. He fell forward across the 5-yard line, got back up to about the line of scrimmage, but it's going to be fourth down and goal from the 3-yard line. They come to the line.
Well, I'd say we're not going to do anything silly here. We're just going to run the ball.
In motion goes Dontrell Black. Now, Hester's back to pass.
What do I know?
He's going to throw it deep to Dontrell Black. Oh, my goodness sakes. He almost caught that off the deflection. It was deflected by one of the Marion Wildcats, and Black was there and just about hauled it in. And would that not have been remarkable?
Boy, that would have been something, you know.
as they do a great job defensively tonight against Mount Vernon and defeat the Mount Vernon Rams at Marion by a score of 20-7, as you see the scoreboard here. And that's exactly what the halftime score was, too, 20-7. Nobody scored in the second half. From the shotgun, Brown for the Terriers. He's going to keep it on the bootleg this time as he tries to go up the middle, and he's brought down right away by Big Adam Miller and also hit back there by Kyle West.
Get some good field position and take advantage of it.
All right, Carbondale on offense. Brown is under center. Whiteouts on each side. He's going to pass it on a screen pass.
Get on that ball. That is a fumble.
Thompson picks it up.
That's going to be seven.
That is Joe Rush, who picked up the loose ball, and he's in the end zone.
Yes, sirree.
And it is a fumble and a touchdown for the Rams.
You talk about the turnover. You bet we got it.
Prayer is answered for the Rams as they get on the board after a costly turnover, as that was a lateral pass out in the backfield there by the Terriers. It was fumbled. Picked up by the Rams as Joel Rush was Johnny on the spot, and he scooped it up just like a center fielder and ran it into the end zone about 18 yards. And the Rams are on the board at 15-6, and now in to add the extra point is Michael Swinnen, the freshman kicker. And he puts it up, and he splits the uprights. It's good. So the Rams are on the board. From the shotgun, Brown rolls out to his right. He's pursued by the Rams, and he's brought down by several Ram tacklers back there. In pursuit was Ian Reagan, and in on the stop was Bradford as well as Jeremiah McGovern. Yeah. Snap is good, and here is the punt. And it's fielded by Simmons at the 40.
Hit that wall.
Goes off to the right. He's got running room.
He's got room.
Down the sideline. Breaks a tackle. Cuts back in. Gets deep into Terrier territory at the 26-yard line. A great return by Mitch Simmons, as the Rams will have great field position, first and 10, deep in Terrier territory with the score at 21-7 at 5.
Come on, Mr. Clinton, get that big old horse and take it right over
there
with you.
You see Jordan over the ball at the 2-yard line. Rams with everybody untied. Here's his quarterback sneak, and all the way through easily is Jacob Alves as he dove between the center and the guard, and he is in the end zone for a 2-yard touchdown run, and it's 21-13. Rams back to within 8.
Here we come, right back in it.
On for the extra point will be Michael Swinnen. As you see the cheerleaders looking on, they're back in the contest now. Here's the snap. Hester on the hold, Swinnen on the kick, and it's beautiful right through the uprights. It's good. And the Rams are back within 7 points. 2:43 to play here on the right, under center. It's Jacob Alves.
We got room.
Chicken Stuckey around the left side.
Yes, sir.
Close to a Ram first down.
Well, I tell you what I like about that play is Chicken initiated the contact right there as he rolled that corner.
He sure did. He ducked the shoulder and said, if you're going to bring me down, I'm going to make you pay.
You bet he did.
Carbondale fans starting to whoop it up here.
All right, pick up about half of it here. If we can't get it, we'll go for it on fourth and get it.
Wants to pass again. Looks over to the left. It's complete to Chicken Stuckey.
Set
He's got
up.
Blockers in front of him.
He's gone.
Down the sideline, and it's a touchdown
round. No yellow hankies on the field.
27-yard touchdown pass on a screen from Jacob Alves to Chicken Stuckey as he rumbles down the left sideline and scores for the Rams. And
yep, another big third down play.
See defensive coordinator Mark Goodhart along the sideline.
Double wide receivers to the left.
First time we've seen him with doubles to the left. Brown under center again, and he's going to roll out to his left. He's pursued by Sledge, and he's brought down as the Rams converge and bring him down for a loss.
Number 68.
That was Jeremiah McGovern on the sack. Great pursuit by the Rams that time. It's all tied up at 21-21. Rams trying to drive in for the game-winning score here. Ball to 29-yard line, first and 10 for Mount Vernon. Jacob Alvis, the quarterback. Hester's playing tight end, and he leads a block here as sweeping around the left side is Chicken Stuckey, and he gets running room.
I think he ran out of bounds
there. He did run out of bounds at about the 15-yard line.
He's going to get a first down.
But not till he got another first down. Good run there by Chicken Stuckey, and boy, was he moving at that time.
Yeah, and he got out of bounds to stop the clock with 2:22 to go.
Wideouts to the left and the right. Alvis takes a snap. He wants to pass.
There he
looks
is.
Over the middle.
Hello.
Complete touchdown. You called it, Mr. Announcer.
Hello.
We missed it the first time around, but we got it this time. Beautiful pass play. It works this time as the pass is complete for a touchdown for the Rams. Beautiful play over the middle as Jacob Alvis looks up with Joel Rush. And
look at that time left on that clock, too.
Yes, down to 27 seconds left.
I think it's pretty obvious in Carbondale you can't celebrate a touchdown.
Either way, that's right.
That's three out of four that's been called, two on the Terriers and one on the Rams. Test Michael Swinnen's late.
Yeah, he'll try one from the 35-yard line now, or 35 yards out for the extra point. He puts the foot to it. I think he's got it. He does. 35 yards out.
35 yards out, and it could have went another 10.
Oh, my goodness sakes. Great extra point kick there by Michael Swinnen, the freshman, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, freshman. And with 27 seconds left on the clock, the Rams lead this one 28-21. And, Marty, it's our first lead of the football game. Game is over. It's in the books. Rams win this one over the Terriers on homecoming in Carbondale. Final score, Mount Vernon 28, Carbondale 21. As you see, the coaches come out and greet each other at midfield. Second down and two now, the ball at 45. Pitch out to Joel Rush, coming around the left-hand side. Good block by Bradford. He turns the corner, gets across the 35 up to the 31-yard line before he's brought down. And on the stop for Cahokia was Myron Washington. That is another Ram first down at the 32-yard line. Great block by Bradford that time. First and 10. Here's a pitch out to Joel Rush again as he sweeps around the right-hand side. He's got running room into the secondary. Can he stay on his feet? He gets down to about the 5-yard line before he's brought down. Great determination there by Joel Rush. What more can you say, Marty?
Yes, it was.
Love to see that on a night like tonight with the adversity that he and his family have faced this week. And for Joel to carry the ball like that in that situation in a game that's lopsided like this is really something.
Yeah, and it's hard to believe, but he just crossed the century mark. That was his 18th carry on the night, 113 yards. And
well, how fitting to do it on a long carry like that.
Absolutely. Let's just get him in the end zone.
First down and goal for the Rams at the 7-yard line. Joel Rush on the carry again. He tries to get back. It's in the books. It's all Cahokia tonight as they win this one decisively over the Rams by the score of 39-0. Two wideouts to the right, one to the left, and operating from the shotgun is quarterback Dayton Spears, and he looks out to the left. He's going to throw it deep. He's got a man out there, and it's just about picked off.
I think
and
it is picked off.
It was tipped by Joel Rush, and as he fell to the ground, he came up with the reception, or the interception, I should say. Cardinals and the Mets tonight from Shea Stadium. Here's a pitch out on second down. And it goes to Dontrell Black, and he's got great yardage into Centralia territory. First down yardage, in fact, all the way up to the 45-yard line. So there we are, moving the chains on the second play of the game, Marty.
21-yard pickup. That's good to see Dontrell back in the lineup.
Simmons will be punting from about his own 35-yard line. So he's in to get the snap. It's a good snap. And Simmons puts the foot into it. It's a nice high punt coming down at about the 20-yard line, and it's fumbled, and the Rams are on it. Adrian Dabney tried to make the catch. He fumbled it, went right through his fingers, and the Rams recover the football and will take over at about the 17-yard line.
Fourth and two. Looks like a little longer than two. They're going to go with the field goal.
Field goal units coming in. And coming in to try to attempt the field goal will be freshman Michael Swinnen. And they'll be spotting the ball on the snap at about the, on the hold rather, at about the 17-yard line. So it'll be a 27-yard field goal attempt by Swinnen. Snap is down. The kick is up. And it is good. Michael Swinnen splits the uprights. And the Rams are on the board. Orphan's rush another player out on the field on the line real quick. Tietzen's back to pass, or back to punt again. Snap is high, but he handles it, and it's blocked. It's blocked. And it's going to be recovered by the Rams at the 48-yard line. Jumping on the football is Trevante Badger. Trevante Badger picks up the block punt. That snap was high, and that cost the punter just enough time to where the Rams were able to penetrate and get in there and get a hand on the ball and block it. Badger comes up with recovery, and the Rams will take over first and 10 at the 49. One and goal from about the 2 to 2.5 yard line. Alves out to Dontrell Black, looks for running room, slices in, and he's in the end zone. Touchdown Rams. Dontrell Black from 2 yards out. Deers will try the extra point instead of Swinnen. Hester on the hold, Sears on the kick. It looks good, it is good. Extra point is good by Sears. Rams try to put it in the end zone again as we near the red zone. The Diamond T formation in the backfield again.
And I like it, again. I like
Look
it.
At that, Joel Rush all the way, 21 yards for a touchdown. Misdirection play. As he came with a full head of steam out of the backfield and was untouched into the end zone, 21 yards. In the third quarter, and the Rams leading it 24-10 as the defense did their job. Now the offense goes back to work. Everybody in tight.
Good block,
Stuckey gets Stuckey.
Good block,
oh, look
and
at
he's
the cutback.
Gone.
Great cutback by Stuckey. Can anybody catch
no
him? One guy's got
a
shot. He's down the sideline, and he's gone as he completely outruns Ted Fee. Into the end zone, down the sideline. How about that? 59 yards on the again single setback.
Oh.
There's a bad snap, but he comes up with the ball. Now he's rushed, rolls out to his left, gets rid of the football, throws it deep. Chance for an interception, and it is. Good defense there. Inside the receiver again was Joel Rush, as he saw it all the way. The football game. It's in the books. The Rams have picked up their fifth victory of the season. Final score is Mount Vernon 38, Centralia 17. Rams now 5-3 on the season. The Orphans drop to 0-8. Defeated 8-0, Metamora Redbirds, ranked number 2 in the state of Illinois in Class 5A. Under center this time is Zimmerman. And he's going to keep the football. Tries to come back the other way, and he's tripped up. Tripped up by Trevante Badger. I don't know if that was a busted play or if he just was trying to reverse direction on his own.
That kind of looked like a busted play to me.
That'll bring up second down and 12 for the Rams after the loss of two on the play. Under center again is Alvis. Man in motion is Dontrell Black, and Alvis is dropping back to pass. He's pursued, gets off the pass to Joel Rush. Rush breaks one tackle. He's still on his feet. Gets across the 40, and he's knocked out of bounds at about the 41-yard line as Teague Tendino made the stop for the Metamora Redbirds, but very close to a Ram first down, and it is. They'll move the chains. Mount Vernon first down on a nice pass play to Joel Rush, and he did a great job of breaking a tackle.
Well,
and staying
he sure
on his feet, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Individually, he turned a 5-yard loss into a 12-yard gain.
That pushes it back to the 27-yard line. Second and 12 for the shotgun of Zimmerman. He's got a wide out to the right and the left, and he looks to his left and throws
intercepted.
It. And it's picked off by Trevante Badger. And that is the best field position of the game so far for the Rams as Mount Vernon offense will come onto the field, take over at the Metamora 31-yard line. All right, Alvis under center. Three-headed monster in the backfield. And here's the gift. Look
gone.
At this. Joel Rush, he's going to bust it all the way to the end zone. 33 yards, touchdown. Joel Rush explodes out of the backfield, and the Rams are on the board on a touchdown dash by Joel Rush. That makes it 30-6. And that gives the Ram fans something to cheer about.
Well, it sure does, because Joel Rush just went over the 1,000-yard mark.
That is fantastic. Congratulations, Joel. And in to tack on the extra point attempt will be Michael Swinnen. Hester on the hold. There's a snap. The kick is up, and it's a beauty. All righty. That brings up first and 15 now. Ball spotted at the 43-yard line of the Rams. And Metamora in with their buddy tight this time. And they're going to give it to a sweep on the right-hand side to Adam Dubendack, and the ball's loose on the ground. Who's got it?
Not
I think the Rams got it. They sure did. Dubendack lost the ball, and coming out of there with it is Jake Sterner. Jake Sterner recovers the fumble for the Rams, and Mount Vernon takes over at their own 42-yard line, and that's a big break. Alvis under center, and in motion again is Chicken Stuckey. And Stuckey gets the keep. Look at this. He's into the secondary. Breaks one tackle. Breaks another. Spins and gets the ball up to about the 27-yard line, rather, where he's brought down. But it's another Ram first down. Boy, he hit that hole hard that time.
Yes, he did.
Nice carry by Chicken Stuckey for the Ram first down. And we're moving the chains.
We're going to kick a field goal here.
In to try the field goal will be the freshman Michael Swinnen, and the ball will be snapped and placed at the 15-yard line, maybe the 16-yard line, so call it a 26-yard field goal attempt here. And snap is down, kick is up, it's high enough, it's long enough, and it's good. Michael Swinnen splits the uprights, and the field goal is good for the Mount Vernon Rams. Long drive for the Rams. Wanted to get it in the end zone, but they settled for the field goal, but that makes the score 30-10. Second down and 22 for Mount Vernon. Two wide right, two wide left, as back to pass is Alvis, and he's got a man open. It's Dontrell Black. He's got it. He crosses over. Two defenders to beat. He's on his horse into Redbird territory, where he's brought down at the 35-yard line.
Punch that ticket.
Quarterback sneak, what do you think? Alvis, he keeps it, lowers the head. He's in there. Touchdown, Jacob Alvis. And the Rams score again. Second touchdown of the game for the Rams. That's going to be the football game. Metamora wins this football game by a score of 37-17 to go 9-0, a perfect regular season. The Rams drop to 5-4. You see the players and coaches come out to greet each other at midfield. at the Marion 35-yard line. In motion is Dontrell Black. Alvis looking to pass. Over the middle, he's got Hester. It's complete across the 25 to the 23-yard line, where he's brought down by football game at Marion. But the Rams getting close to the red zone here. They spread the field. Wide outs to the left. Now in motion is Chicken Stuckey to the right. And here's the give up the middle to Joe Rush. He busts into the secondary, and he's going to score. Touchdown, Joe Rush, from 23 yards out. And I don't know that anybody had a hand on him at all. A precarious situation. Let's see what happens. Here's the snap. It's down. Hester, good on the hold. The kick is up, and it's good. He split the uprights. Give him credit.
That'd be great.
Second down and 10 for the Wildcats. There's a bad snap, but Brown picks it up. He's looking to pass. He does. It's knocked away and intercepted by the Rams.
That's Sterner.
Sterner comes up with a pick, but first getting the hand on it was Nick Bradford. Nick. All right. Badger out wide left along with Chicken Stuckey. And we got Hester along with Dontrell Black wide right. Here's a pass.
He's open.
In the end zone and falling down. Touchdown. But catching it. He fell down, but he still caught it.
It's Dontrell.
Dontrell Black with a great reception and caught it while he was flat on his back. And we got a penalty against the Rams.
He'll go again, Randy.
Got the wind at our back this time. Mm-hmm. Ball's at the 22-yard line, and let's see what Michael Swinnen can do.
It's going to be about a 40-yard field goal attempt. 39.
He'll be holding at the 29. That'll make it a 39-yard field goal attempt. Again, it's well within the range of the freshman. Snap. Hester holds it. Kick is up. It's long enough. And it's good.
Wow.
How about that? A 39-yard field goal for the Rams. In motion is Chicken Stuckey. Alvis fakes it to Stuckey. Instead, hands it up the middle to Joe Rush. He's got running room across the 50 to the 45, across the 40 to the 35, across the 30. Driven out of bounds at about the Marion 21-yard line. A great run by Joel Rush. And finally, Rams knocking at the door in the red zone here. Trying to answer back on Marion's touchdown a few moments ago. Wide right is Hester. In the slot is Dontrell Black. Also two receivers wide to the left. Now Black goes in motion. Here's a pitch out to Joel Rush. Rush cuts it back. Gets over the five and into the end zone. Touchdown. 6-yard touchdown run by Joel Rush. And just like that, the Rams do answer back offensively. And that makes the score 21-16. We've got a great football game going on here in the Class 5A playoffs. They got one wide out to the left. They got a couple of receivers in the slot on the right. And here they pass it out.
Good job, Derek. Good job, Derek Hensley.
Fumble's caused by the ground.
No, so yeah, it's down.
Pass was out there to the right. Screen pass to
Justin
Marshall.
They're calling that an incomplete pass.
Oh, that, no. He caught that ball.
Hey, and I'll tell you what, Randy.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. You look over at Dan Mings, and he is livid.
Well, I'm going to tell you what.
He is absolutely livid.
Well, that should be Ram football, and I'll tell you why. That pass was not a forward pass.
That was a lateral.
Yes, it was, and he called that an incomplete pass. Big break for the Wildcats.
Mount Vernon coaching staff is incensed over there.
To get this 15 yards and pick up that first down.
All right. Back to the field we go, and here it is, 4th and 15 from the Marion 42-yard line. Rams need a first down. In motion, Chicken Stuckey. Alvis rolls out, looking to pass. Gets rid of it to Stuckey. He catches
move.
It. He's got running room.
He got
gets
it.
Gets up the sideline. He's got a first down.
He got
first down, Chicken Stuckey, as the Rams celebrate along the sideline. As Stuckey gets the ball across the 30-yard line to about the 28, it's going to be a Ram first down. How about that?
Awesome play. A good Jeff Lonnen. He sends one deep, clears the area, and Stuckey, the motion man, peels off into the flats, picks it up, and makes one move and picks up the first down.
We needed 15, and Stuckey got 16. And the Rams
Yep, right here's your ball game.
32 seconds on the clock. After the timeout, the players are back out on the field. Somebody's going to advance here in the Class 5A playoffs. Somebody's going home. This is the play. Rams spread the field. Alves wants to pass. Rolls out to the right. Looks for a target. He's got to complete the chicken. Stuckey. Stuckey gets the ball up to the 5-yard line.
Short,
it's going to be just
down.
A little bit short. 1 yard short. 1 yard short. We needed to get to about the 4. Stuckey was tackled at the 5-yard line, and the Marion Wildcats are going to take over on downs with 24 seconds left on the clock. The Marion Wildcats have survived. They have held off the Mount Vernon Rams here in a rematch of two South 7 Conference rivals. As Marion wins this football game by a score of 21-17 as they stop the Rams at the 5-yard line.
That's why we play. That's why we work. We have a chance to win at the end. I mean, the things that you guys did this week in practice, the things that you guys have done all season, you got us here, and you know what? It came down to us having one chance to win. We came up, what? I don't know. 3 feet short, something like that. But guys, you know what? Very proud of you. Seniors, I wish we could have done something for you. I really wish we could have done something for you. Love you very much. We grew up a little bit this year as people. We grew probably more as people than we did as a football team. We probably did. We probably learned some things this year about ourselves and about each other. You know what? That's probably what I'm going to take. I take something from every season. And that's probably what I'm going to get to take and keep in my heart a little bit. You got to be better people. You got to be better people. You learn some lessons that were tough. My God, you learned some lessons that were tough. But you know what? You guys hold your heads up high when you get off here. Because that was a football game, boys. That was one heck of a football game. Proud of you. The tradition's alive. The tradition keeps going. We keep building. We keep going to the playoffs. Our time's going to come. Our time's going to come. This is something that we tell our seniors, and we've already talked to our seniors a little bit about it. But we learned this lesson along the way. Life is short. Life is short. I think in the Bible it says it's a vapor. You never know when it's going to come. You never know when it's going to be over. So why not give everything you've got all the time? Play hard, love hard, live hard. Why not? You never know. I love you. I'm proud of you. We're going to get back to Mount Vernon. You guys get one more break right here. This is the last time this group's going to be together. Make it proud. Then you jog off this field with your heads high, with pride about what you've done and the things that you're going to continue to do. You know, it was just a heck of an effort. That was a great football game to be a part of. And, you know, I knew our kids wouldn't stop fighting for us. I knew that. And you know what? We came out. We left everything on the field. We did everything that we possibly could to win this football game. And, you know, it came down to the last 30 ticks, and we fell about a yard and a half short. You know, that's all you ever want. You want a chance to be in football games. You want a chance to be respectable. You want a chance to win. And we gave ourselves that chance. And we just came up a little short. You know, I love my kids. Been through a lot. And those seniors deserve, you know, a big pat on the back. But the whole team, they just grew up this year as men and had to face some things that they... young kids should have to face. But I'm so proud of them. You know, tradition's alive. You know, we went back to the playoffs. We're gonna continue to go back. We're gonna continue to fight. And you know, someday it'll be our time. But this year, you know, came up against a better football team, and they beat us. So I'm proud of the effort. I'm proud of the year that we had. We have nothing to hang our heads about, and we'll just go from there.
Congratulations, Rams, on another good football season. We can't wait until next year.